being aware of the past and being confident and empowered as we move into the future. It's a really difficult moment. See what they did? Because we talked about this.
You know, we have to be very specific about who our community is. And our community, our people, are the people who are excluded, are the people who aren't invited into the circles, and are the people who are struggling, who need, who are...
Seen a young man, used to be hanging out at the Peace Park, pulled in him and his crew. We're gonna have dance parties here, we're gonna have the open mics here. Pulled this crew in, we rocking. Teenagers, they at the Peace Park. After school, they rocking. It's fun. Relationships being forged. I would see him almost every day, him and his crew. I said, young boy, what's up? Where everybody at? Man, this neighborhood dead. Put his head down and walked off. Walking away from the neighborhood, places that we used to be at. That's difficult. That's tough. When I spoke to my neighbor across the fence, she said, this is just not right. She said, them people over there, they can't even get to their house. She said, ain't nobody telling us nothing. She said, I don't know what's going on. A lot of small businesses closed down in recent months. So it's difficult. So those are the emotions that I was navigating last night, and I became really angry. Became very angry at those forces who are responsible for this situation. Knowing that voices that's in this room right now, and voices such as you all, had worked to offer wisdom and to try to advise PHA and powerful forces to not do what could be avoided.
Where we have public-private institutions working together to produce outcomes in distressed communities. And when you read these policies, you're like, oh, okay, that might sound interesting, but in practice, you're like, so you're just trying to figure out different ways of tearing down public housing, pushing people out, and saying, here's a voucher, figure out where you're going to live, and hopefully you find somewhere to build a new life. And when that program came to Yonkers, and being a part of an organization and other housing groups that were fighting around that policy to make sure that it actually had residents' voices involved in it, and in the decision-making policy, we were like, oh my goodness, if it came to one of our cities, we'll be organized, what would we do? And in 2013, it came to Yonkers. And we were asked by the city of Yonkers to be a part of that process, because we had been holding them accountable around community engagement, around community development block grant funds, and making sure they're letting community residents know what meetings were, and also saying, you know what, this program isn't the best program, because things haven't happened, and why is this being funded versus this? So actually having community voices about that process. So when Choice Neighborhoods came, we said, well, we actually want to make sure that this is done in a way that respects communities, that it doesn't leave voices outside of the room who are going to be directly impacted, that is not just another way of doing a project, coming up with plans with no community input, and then saying, okay, just live with what the change was, because you have no say in the process. And we made it clear as Community Voices Heard that we were against that. We wanted to make sure that community residents were involved in the process from the very beginning, and would push back hard, or if we didn't like what we heard or saw, or something changed in the plan that wasn't agreed upon, or just said, you know what, we're not going to be involved in the process anymore. And they understood that, and they heard that, and there were multiple fights that we had as an organization with the planning department because of what they thought a neighborhood plan should
be. Without control over the means of life and production. Simple as that. We need us some green earth. We need us some space in order to do our thing. Can't do my thing under you. And I'm speaking to the imperialists, I'm speaking to the capitalists, I'm speaking to the authorities in the society. I can't do my thing. My thing, and I don't mean me, I mean us, is creativity. We say that in the midst of want, in the midst of hunger, in the midst of miseducation, idleness, insecurity, the act of transforming your environment, the act of transforming the land, the alchemy of solving your own problems, the creative act. We say that's the joy of life right there. Every human being has the right to some green earth from this land, the ability to poke it, ability to imagine, and to implement. That's life. That's the stuff that it's made of. And in our situation, that's the therapeutic solution. Briefly, I would like to just share with you the experience of the North Philly Peace Park, and I don't want to go over too much time. I'd like to share our experience. Our experience was a community like many communities, faced with these two problems, the problems of property rights and the problem of lack of local democracy. 2012, community members took action, because this property rights thing, man, that keep me up at night. Property rights, you're going to have some land to be able to do what you need to do. But what happened if all the land is under a fictitious claim? Fictitious claim. What did you do? The people starve and the stomachs are growling. Real talk. Picked up this newspaper the other day talking about how in the last 10 years here in Philadelphia, food insecurity rose by 60%. One-third of the city population is starved. So we're looking at that. We know that the young people are being devoured in the streets because of the situation the state created with schooling cut program. What do we do? Time is ticking. All around you is vacant land. The vacant land is kept in a decrepit state to affect you and to further demoralize you. Meanwhile, you're hungry, you're uneducated, you're idle. What do you do? You must stand up and you must challenge power. You must be daring and courageous and decisive.
So after performing 325 interviews, we had a report back on findings from the listening project to all of the participants. And at that report back, we determined that the Community Land Trust would be the best steward to bring vacant land back to use for community control. And a Community Land Trust is a nonprofit organization that holds land and develops that land for housing, parks, agriculture, commercial uses, but keeps that land off of the speculative market. So it's most often used and accredited with stopping gentrification around its use of permanently affordable homes for homeownership that are sold below market rate and can't be sold at market rate. But in order to fulfill the vision of the Community Justice Land Trust, we needed land. We knew there was land, 79 football fields worth of land, but we couldn't get it because it was owned by private individuals, many of them had tax liens or violations, or they were owned by many different city entities with a lot of different processes for getting it. So we needed a tool to help us get land for our Community Land Trust. So we launched a campaign to take back vacant land in 2011, and it was a coalition of faith, labor, agriculture, community groups, disability rights groups, who had come together to win a land bank in Philadelphia. And a land bank is a municipal entity that uses tax foreclosure to put land back into productive use, and it can clear liens and violations which might prevent that land from being sold. And we didn't want just any land bank. We wanted a land bank that we could actually trust. We wanted a land bank that we could actually, that wouldn't give land to just the highest bidder. So we have three main values. The value that the land bank be fair, so that land can go to equitable development, so affordable housing, parks, open space, urban agriculture, assigned rear lots, land for commercial development that would create family-sustaining jobs. We wanted it to be accountable, so we wanted it to have four seats. Well, we ended up with four seats, but we wanted it to have seats on the board for community representation. We wanted it to be transparent, so we wanted to know who was getting the land, for how much, and how much money would the end user be making. So what would be the income of the people who might be buying a house, having a job on the land? We wanted annual impact statements on the goals.
I'm finding so many different mentalities. It seems challenging. I don't say hard because only things hard is the concrete that you walk on. Everything else is a challenge. So I'm ready for this challenge. And I was built for this. I think we all have a purpose in life, and mine's going to take on a task that most will back away from. People say it's impossible. I see possibilities. I don't see anything as being impossible.